Though we saw destruction like never before, so many of us chose to hang in there and chose to rebuild.
Yeah, people have fought relentlessly to stay in familiar surroundings. And some of those hardest fighters are just across the bridge from us at Fort Myers Beach.
Yeah, and for the past year or so, that's where we always seem to find Wink News reporter Michael Hudak, on Fort Myers Beach. Michael, can you tell us about the decisions people on the beach have had to make?
Well, it's probably the most difficult decision they'll ever have to make in their lives. It's bad enough that their property got damaged or wiped out to the point where they have to relocate their entire lives. It can be a double-edged sword either way, depending on who you ask. If they decide to sell, that means that their whole life was displaced. That's difficult enough. Plus, selling on the beach is not very easy right now because of interest rates and other factors. If they decide to stay and rebuild, we've heard from tons of people that the permitting process on the beach is tumultuous and has been for the last 12 months. So I went to the primary people selling property on this beach, and I asked them, should they stay or should they go? If you want to know about the real estate market on Fort Myers Beach after Hurricane Ian,
there's a lot of memories, a lot of livelihoods that pretty much were taken away.
All you have to do is look around. You can't go 100 feet on the beach without tons of for sale signs catching your eye.
A lot of properties, vacant lots, where people have decided that they need to move on.
But are there so many signs because the real estate market is booming right now, or have they sat idle like this for 12 months?
So can we see the downstairs?
Absolutely.
You said a lot of this was remodeled after the storm, or most of it.
Downstairs, absolutely.
I set out to find out what these signs mean.
You don't see a lot of cars around right now, and it's just typical of this time of year. So that's why you're seeing a lot of signs that are staying there for a long time.
I spoke to four real estate agents on the beach, Alex King, Jorge Barrera, Dennis Wagaman, and Rachel Rose Danzi, to get that answer.
In spite of all the challenges that we've all had to deal with, the real estate market is very active.
What does that mean to you when you see that many signs everywhere?
Well, it means opportunity. We're going through a revival.
I think it's a typical summer. I think that, you know, the investors are coming in that see what this is going to be in the next 5 to 10 years, and it's going to be a new beautiful island.
But not everything is so peachy.
How long do you think it's going to take to get this place hustling and bustling?
Give us permits.
Okay, explain.
Well, we've been waiting now for 6 months or so for a permit on one of our properties on the south end.
Danzi tells me that the process is tedious and holding back progress. So I went to the town of Fort Myers Beach to learn more about the permitting process. They tell me they've been inundated with permits since the hurricane, but are working through everything as fast as possible. And it is not all sunshine and roses when it comes to selling Fort Myers Beach. I interviewed a man who bought a property 2 months before Hurricane Ian hit, and he still has not been able to list the property for sale yet because of delays in repairing it. You will hear his story only on Wink News tonight at 11 o'clock. For now, reporting live on Fort Myers Beach, Michael Hudak, Wink News.